You know, the main thing is followed in IT sector is the Taylorist method, which was invented by a Taylor for increasing more production, followed in IT sector, where the worker is given particular target, he has to fulfill the target within a period of time. Now we can move to next page. In the next page we can see box 5.5. In a speedy way I want to go through that. It means time slavery in the IT sector. IT sector brings slavery, means each worker is treated as a slave, because for example each worker has to work 10 to 12 hours. It means they have to spend up to overnight. This is called a night out. We know that throughout the day and he up to night, it means 10 to 12 hours each worker has to work up to night. They have to work night out because there is a project deadline is there. If they have to work the, if they have to produce something, if it takes more time, if that production is going to be over, if that target is going to be over, so that they have to spend up to evening. In a simple way I wanted to tell you that if the workers are given some target, the time is not the matter. It means they are given the target and within few week they have to finish the target. If the target is not finished, the worker has to work for the night up to the evening. Then work culture. Work culture means what? The worker has to spend long working hours. This is the work culture in the IT sector. Third one, we know that the IT sector, which what we can say helps the client. In call centers we know that especially the call centers are bringing the service. We know that they are helping the people in different countries and they are giving the advices who belong the people who belong to different countries. So in America, in United States, their working day, what we can say, begins when in India evening begins. We know that in United States their working day begins when in India evening starts. It means the in call centers the worker has to work during evening, in the evening, because they are giving service to the people who are in America, United States. Their day time difference is there when we compare America and India. Then they have to, what we can say, finish the work within the day. And man day means what? Based on an 8-hour day, they have to work for 8 hours, 10 to 12 hours. Then if the work is not over up to night, they have to work. Then flexi time means what? The company is giving flexible time period to the people. Company is asking which time period is better for you. It means morning 10 to evening 7 or night 7 to morning 5. It means which time is comfortable for the worker, the company is giving and the worker can select. But the worker has to work for particular hours, whatever may be the period. Then next one is that the worker has to finish the task, and so that in this way, for impressing the boss, the worker, they are pretending they are hard working. They are working hard for getting the appreciation from the boss. This is what happening in IT sector. In a simple way, I wanted to tell you that it means average working hours 10 to 12 hours, because the average working hours in an IT sector is 10 to 12 hours, because night out process is there. It means up to the night the worker has to work if the target is not completed. Second point. Third point, what we can say, work culture. Work culture means in an IT sector, long working hours has to be followed by the worker. Third point. Fourth point, what we can say, flexi time. Flexi time means each worker is given freedom by the company to select which time period is better for him or her for working. Last point we can say, for getting the appreciation from the boss, each worker is working hard. Now we can move to next page, the same page and the next paragraph, the page number 84, the first paragraph. We can say that as a result of these working hours in places like Bangalore, Hyderabad and Gurgaon, it means these are the places IT sectors are there. A lot of workers are working up to night. A deadline is there. They are given deadline of finishing the work. So up to night they have to work. They have to leave their families and they have to leave their children. Where many IT firms and call centers are located, shops and restaurants have also changed their opening hours and are open late. If both husband and wife work, then children have to be put in crutches. The joint family, which was supposed to have disappeared with industrialization, seemed to have re-emerged as grandparents are robbed in means what? To persuade something to do something in to help with their children. In a simple way, I want to tell you that there are IT sector cities like Bangalore, Hyderabad and Gurgaon where both husband and wife, they are working together, and sometimes day shift is there, sometimes night shift is there. If day shift is there, the children will be looked after in crutches, and if night shift is there, the children will be looked after by the grandparents. So the grandparents are taking care of the children. A type of joint family re-emerged, which was lost. The joint family system was stopped during industrialization, which began because of the people, because of the new working hours which happens in IT sector. Then we can move to next paragraph. Next paragraph concentrates on some important topic like the knowledge economy. We have to understand the meaning of knowledge economy. Here we can say one important debate in sociology is whether industrialization and the shift to services and knowledge-based work like IT leads to greater skills in society. We know that for working in IT sector, we need more skill. Production is more. There is a difference between traditional work and IT sector. We know that because in IT sector we have to adopt more skills and knowledge. We have to apply more knowledge. We should understand how to operate computers. So in IT sector, in industries, we need to apply more knowledge based skills. We often hear the phrase knowledge economy to describe the growth of IT in India. But how do you compare the skills of a farmer who knows how to grow the soil, many hundreds of crops relying on his or understanding of the weather, the soil and the seeds, with the knowledge of a software professional. It means knowledge economy means the people who are working in IT sector, they are making use of their knowledge for the production. Knowledge, that is why it is called a knowledge economy. Economy, economic achievement or economic development by using knowledge in IT sector. Then what about the farmers? They are also having knowledge and they are also having traditional intelligence about the seed, about the weather, because a farmer should understand the weather, about the weather, about the seed, about the soil, how to do farming, so that he also contributes very much for the economic development. We cannot underestimate him. We cannot say that farmer is inferior and the IT sector worker is superior. Both are working for the economic development, and IT sector employee or the worker who is working in IT sector, he is not more skilled than a farmer, because farmer is using his skill, his knowledge, his traditional ideas, and IT sector is using his own ideas. So both are working hard for the betterment of society, because both are contributing well to the society. Both are skilled in different ways, even though two different occupation is there, two different job is there, and both are very much skilled in their own, what we can say, area. The famous sociologist Harry Braverman is an American sociologist, and he told that, argues that the use of machinery actually skills workers, for example, whereas earlier architects and engineers had to be skilled draughtsmen, now the computer does a lot of work for them. It means the sociologist like Harry Braverman, he gives more importance to traditional idea. For example, in the past, before the coming of industrialization, the engineers, the architects, they are drawing with their hand. The architects, they are drawing with their hand. Now computer is there for the same purpose. So the emergence of the modernism, emergence of this kind of replacement, the traditional original skill is lost. It means now the architect, they are not drawing with their hand, they are taking the help of computer for drawing. Now the human skill is replaced by the skill which is done by the machines. The machines are replacing human skills. But sociologists, they give more importance to the original traditional skill done by or exhibited by, displayed by human beings, which is better than that of computer skills. Draughtsman means what? One who makes detailed plans for drawing. It means in the past, the architect and engineers, they should be draughtsmen, because they have to draw themselves. So they were very much skilled for drawing, for planning. Now everything is done by computer. Then next paragraph, working conditions. We can understand that we all want a solid house. We need basic things like solid house, clothes, other goods, but we should understand that these come to us because someone is working to produce them. Now we are living in a good house, we are wearing beautiful clothes, but we have to understand that there are some people who are working behind that in a bad condition, because in industries a lot of people are working and they are exploited there, they have to work more. We are wearing the dress, we are living in a house, and there is a lot of work behind that done by other human beings. First point. Second point, the role of government. What was done by government? The government has passed a number of laws to regulate working condition. It means the government passed some, what we can say, some rules and regulations to regulate, means to control working condition. It means government wishes that the worker in an industry should work in a peaceful way. Second point. Third point, let us look at mining. We know that mining is the industry where a lot of people are working in a bad condition. They are exploited very much, and mining workers, a number of people are working there, especially in coal mines. We know that the people are working in coal mine, they are suffering because of the chemical gases. So they are facing a lot of problems that I will explain. In coal mines, around employ 5.5 lakh workers in India. Only in coal mine, about 5.5 lakh workers are working. Next point. Third, next point. The Mines Act 1952 specifies the maximum number of hours a person can be made of work in a week. So that government introduced an act. The name of the act is the Mine Act, which came in 1952, which says that, what we can say, a person should be given some kind of relaxation, because this act specifies the maximum number of hours a person can work in a week. So this Mine Act 1952 is important for the worker. It stops exploitation, because before that the workers were working, there is no control, there is no particular time period for working. When this Mine Act came into existence, it put some control over the working hour by the workers. Then next point, the need to pay overtime for extra hours. It means the company or the industry have to pay extra money if the worker is working for extra hours. Then, and the safety rules. This Mine Act emphasizes on particular time period. It means reduce the time period for the worker in a week. Second one, the company have to pay extra work, extra payment if the worker is working extra time. Then safety rules. The company should ensure that there is safe atmosphere for the workers, because in coal mines it is very dangerous to work. The people are being killed by the atmosphere. About that I will tell you. The people are catching sick, and the people are catching diseases. So in many ways the people are suffering in coal mines. These rules may not be followed in big companies. Big mining companies are following that, but small companies, they are not following coyotes, they are not following the rules. Moreover, subcontracting is widespread. Subcontracting means what? The main company, they are, what we can say, giving the work to other company or other people. This is called subcontract. Subcontract means the main company is making some agreement with the other contractors. They are called subcontractor, and for distributing the main company's work to other company. Many contractors do not maintain the proper registers of worker, thus avoiding any responsibility for accidents and benefits. After mining has finished in an area, the company is supposed to cover up open holes and restore the area to its early condition, but they don't do this. In a simple way, I wanted to tell you that subcontracting means what? the main company is giving their work to other company or other person. Subcontractor means a person or company to whom the main company is giving the work, so that the subcontractor is taking the work from the main company. So there are workers under the subcontractor, and subcontractor is giving the work to the workers given by the main company to the subcontractor. In a simple way, the main company, they are giving work to the subcontractor. There is an agreement between the main company and subcontractor, and there are workers under subcontractor. So subcontractor is giving the work to the people under him. It is given by the main company. So the subcontractor, he is not taking care of his own workers, and he is not registering the details of the workers. Because of that, if any person dies in the coal mine, there is a chance of death, because danger is there in coal mines. A lot of people are dying, but the subcontractor, he is not revealing or telling the name of the people who are dying. And because a lot of accidents are taking place, a lot of benefits, because of that, the worker should get benefit. Government wishes that if any accident takes place to any worker, there are some benefit to the worker. Because of the subcontractor, he is not registering the name of any worker. Because of that, he will get the benefit, and he will not tell the people who are getting accidents. After mining has finished in an area, the company is supposed to do. After mining takes place in an area, the company has to cover up the open holes when they are taking the coal from the pit. They are digging the earth, but the company has to cover the pit, cover the holes, or restore the area to its earlier condition. But they don't do this. In a simple way, I wanted to tell you that the company who are mining or setting up their mining process on a particular place, after the mining they have to cover the hole, but normally they are not doing it, so that ground became, what we can say, not level, and it is not restoring its earlier condition. Then last paragraph for today's session, it concentrates on the danger, disease and rate of mining accidents which happen in India. We know that workers in underground mine, that means the people who are working in underground for mining purpose, face very dangerous condition. People, they are digging the earth, so that they are facing a lot of problems due to flooding. There is a chance of flood, first point. Then fire, because people who are working in coal mines, there is a chance of fire. Third one, the collapse of roof. The roof can come on them, because it is muddy place, so the roof can come on them, and side can be broken, so that mud can fall upon them. The emission of gases, because they are working in, what we can say, coal mines, and because of that, gases are what we can say coming out, like CH4, CO2. CH4 means methane, CO2 means carbon dioxide. And people who are working in coal mines, there is a chance of emission of gases like CH4 means methane and carbon dioxide. This is affecting the health of the workers. And ventilation failures, many workers develop breathing problems, feeling difficult to breathe when they are in the dig, when they are in the pit, when they are in the hole. Then people are getting diseases like tuberculosis and silicosis, means lung problem in the lungs, lung disease. Those working in overground, it means people who are working on the ground, over the ground, have to work in hot sun. It means direct sunlight is falling upon them. Then rain, they have to work under the rain and face injuries due to mine blasting. People who are breaking the rock, the people, the worker, they have to break the rock so that there's a chance of accidents, chance of falling on them, chance of blasting, then falling objects, etc. The rate of mining accidents in India is very high compared to other countries. So, in a simple way, I wanted to tell you that the people who are working in mines, their condition is very much worse in India. When we compare with other countries, the workers in India, they are facing more problems, because even though rules and regulations are there, but it is not followed in India. This is all about this session. In this session, we have understood many important things. I request all my dear students to read and to write some questions like, what do you mean by outsourcing? First one, second one, give meaning to the term scientific management. Third one, assembly line. Then fourth one, use of machinery in industry, its negative side. Then the working conditions in mines in India. You have to write down answers. So keep learning. God bless you. Thank you.